Adidas put on a lovely spread, girls.
Oh, thank you, Stewie, for my playoffs.
Will you marry me?
Simon Fuller, you're sick.
Balance!
I think I'm pregnant.
You are no longer my son.
Son?
Victoria's pregnancy meant another mouth to feed. The timing couldn't have been worse. The World Cup had just begun, and David had been called to see the England manager, bonkers cripple taunter Glenn Hoddle.
Welcome, David. I knew you would come.
Well, you did say 7 o'clock, Mr. Hoddle.
The cards say... You are preoccupied, David. The cards say your head is full of... posh spice. The cards say I should drop you and pick... David Batty.
Why is that, boss? I get up and down and I'm good from set pieces.
Your temperament is questionable.
But it's not easy when you've got people shouting posh takes it up the arse.
Hold on a sec. I'm getting a message.
Yes. All right, mate. No, I understand, mate. Right. Gotcha. Thanks.
Kurt Cobain says I should start you. You're in.
Thanks. I won't let you or Mr. Cobain down.
Don't you worry about these people shouting out posh takes it up the arse. Bad people all return, but reincarnated as cripples.
They come back disabled? That's amazing. So that means... Stephen Hawking must have been...
Yes, David. Hawking used to be Adolf Hitler.
During the game, David was abused by the dirty Argentinian bastards in a way previously unknown in professional football. But they went too far when they insulted Victoria.
Your wife is very fat, isn't it?
No!
And Beckham has been sent off. If we lose this game now, it's definitely his fault. Christ, what a knob.
Fueled by the British tabloid press, who, as everyone knows, are scum, David's life became a living hell.
Nights in white satin.
With Victoria away conquering America, David went walking, where he didn't know. Until finally, he found himself at a place he recognized.
You.
What are you doing here?
I'm sorry, Mr. Ferguson. I had nowhere else to go.
I knew that woman had ruined you, David Beckham. You're a disgrace.
I'm sorry, Mr. Ferguson. Please, may I come in?
I don't think so, David. You put that woman ahead of me. And now she's let you down, you come crawling back. Well, I won't let you make a fool of me a second time.
Where's it, Mr. Ferguson?
I thought I told you to wait in the studio till you finish the watercolour.
So that's Ruth Van Nistelrooy, your new £90 million signing from AJ.
Aye. He's very talented. He's a real artist, David. He can play on the wing. And he's also good in the box.
I see. Well, I'm sorry to have interrupted your evening, Mr. Ferguson. I'll be on my way.
David, wait! Look at you. You wait through. I'm gonna get out of those clothes and get something warm inside you.
Perhaps some hot chocolate.
Thanks, Mr. Ferguson.
David, remember, things are going to be different this time. Manchester United comes first.
I hear the posh spice.
Okay, Mr. Ferguson. I agree.
For the next few months, David concentrated on what he did best, playing football. Soon he was on top again, and there was better news. He became a father when Victoria gave birth to a lovely boy, Brooklyn. It was obvious what they had to do now, get married, and have teammate and famed raconteur Gary Neville as best man.
And then the ref said, "No, Gary, I'm afraid you are offside." "Offside," he said, "but I was clearly being played onside. What a sweeper!"
Tough crowd. Better knock out the references to Kierkegaard and Sartre.
David, I didn't invite him.
Well.
It seems my invitation got lost in the post.
You're not welcome here, Mr. Ferguson.
Then I'll place this curse on you, Victoria Adams. As long as day follows night, you shall never have a solo number one!
So many presents, but not one from me.
We can't have that now, can we? I don't think you're looking much fit, David. So here's my gift to you. I'll give you a one-on-one training session with me, starting in 4 days' time.
But we've got our honeymoon.
Well, you just have to come back early, won't you? And remember, 4 days' time.
The honeymoon did indeed last 4 days, and while Victoria stayed at Andrew Lloyd Webber's luxury villa in the south of France, the professional David returned to Manchester United for training. Alex Ferguson's increasingly obsessive behaviour and artistic demands would have destroyed a weaker marriage, but following the formal split of the Spice Girls, Victoria felt she owed it to her fans to stay on the cutting edge of music. And who better to help her than Dane Bowers? You know, that fat one out of another level.
So what's it going to sound like, Posh?
Well, we wouldn't want it sounding like the Spice Girls now, would we, Dane?
No, we wouldn't. We want it to sound really street and edgy, don't we?
Exactly. So, how about we make my voice sound like a robot?
That'll be so cool. Like in that Cher song, Believe.
Hey, banging idea. Here, sing through that then.
Hello, 1, 2.
That sounds really great.
Unfortunately, due to Alex Ferguson's curse, the song only reached number 2. And Victoria wasn't the only person beaten into second place by inferior opposition.
So, my FA Cup dreams have been shattered for another year. We lost to Arsenal, the fucking Gooners! But it's all your fault!
What are you talking about, Mr. Ferguson?
I blame you for their second goal!
This isn't about the second goal, is it, Mr. Ferguson? This is about Victoria!
I'm off his, eh? She made you a laughing stock! He came on about getting your face in the papers than he do about getting your head in the 6-yard box!
Calm down, both of you!
Shut up, Ruth Anderson, I! You're a joke, Beckham.
To think I said no when Victoria suggested I transfer to Chelsea.
Huh? So you're going to leave Manchester United, are you? You're going to leave me, huh?
No, Mr. Ferguson. I turned her down.
You're not going anywhere. If I can't have you, no one can!
You got him in the face, Bush! In the face! Oh, my God. What have I done?
David was badly injured. If it had been an Adidas boot with its soft leather and aerodynamic stitching, David would have been fine. But it wasn't. It was a boot by one of Adidas's inferior competitors.
I'll tell you what you've done, Mr. Ferguson. You've set me free!
No, David! No!
The spell you had over me is now broken!
Don't leave me, David! David! Don't leave me, David!
I'm going now, Mr. Ferguson.
We shall never speak again.
Goodbye, all of you. Gary Neville. Call me an ambulance.
What are you going to do, Bex? Where are you
going to
go?
I'm going to Spain, Gary. A lifetime ago, Terry Venables told me something.
Spain's a piece of piss. 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 Piece of piss.
I'm going to Madrid, Gary. Real Madrid. Soon as I get out of hospital.
Cheer up, Mr. Ferguson. You've still got me.
You're nothing compared to David.
Even so, meet me in the showers in 5 minutes. My brushes need cleaning.